Hi, today we're going to use implicit differentiation to find the derivative at a given point. So the function we're given here, 4x squared plus 5x plus xy equals 3, is not solved for y. So one of the options would be to either solve it for y and just use regular differentiation, or just leave it as it is and we'll use our implicit differentiation. Now they give us some information here. They give us this y of 3 equals negative 16. So essentially they're giving us an ordered pair. They're telling us x is 3 and y is negative 16. So we'll need that because when they ask us to get the derivative at 3, we'll be plugging in this point. Okay, so let's start our implicit differentiation. Just to point out that when we do this implicit differentiation, we're going to do the derivative of each term. And if there's a term with a y, when we do the derivative, we're going to put a term of dy dx, a factor of dy dx. Now, this term here, xy, just note that this is going to require a product rule. So that's going to be probably the tricky part of this whole derivative. Okay, so let's begin. So the derivative of 4x squared is going to be just our 8x. Our derivative of 5x is 5. And then here begins our product rule. So the derivative of x is 1 times the y plus the derivative of y, which is 1, but because it's a y term, we have to put a dy dx factor multiplied by the x. Alright, so all of that is the derivative of the xy term equals, and the derivative of a constant of 3 is 0. Okay, so now what we're going to do is solve for the dy dx. So I'm basically going to gather any term with dy dx on one side and throw everything else to the other. So I'm going to push that 8x and 5 and y to the other side. So I'm going to drop these ones. They're not necessary. So I have this dy dx times x equals, and I'm putting 8x to the other side, so it's going to be a negative 8x, a minus 5, and a minus y. And now to solve for dy dx, I'm going to need to divide by x. I'm just going to divide this whole thing here by x and just leave it. There's no real reducing I can do after that. So here's my derivative. So dy dx is going to be negative 8x minus 5 minus y all divided by x. Alright, so then what they asked for is for me to get this derivative at x is 3. Well, I also need to plug in the y value, so now I'm going to plug in my point that's given to me, which is the ordered pair x 3 and y negative 16. So here goes. So I'm going to have a negative x is 3 minus 5 minus the y value, negative 16. And all of that divided by the x value, which is 3. Type it in your calculator, work it out. We're going to end up here with a negative 13 on the top over 3. So what I've come up with is that the derivative at 3 is negative 13 over 3. Okay, so that's how I would get that derivative by implicit differentiation. Now that part's done. Now if you like, I could sort of show you a little trick here too. The function that we started with, the original, if you don't like implicit differentiation and you wanted to solve that for y, we could get the same answer by just using, you know, our regular derivative rule. So let me just, as an aside, show you an alternative way. So if we have this 4x squared, our 5x, our xy equals 3. And let's say I solve for y. So I'm going to throw these x terms to the other side. So I have xy equals 3 minus 4x squared minus 5x. Let's divide by x every term. So when I'm dividing by x, I'm getting my y by itself, so I'm solving it explicitly. So I'm going to have y equals, well, 3 over x, nothing I could do there, minus, I can cancel an x here, 4x minus 5. So here I am solved for y. Now I could do the derivative and plug in 3 just my normal way. Maybe before I do that, let me write this 3 over x as 3x to the negative 1 minus 4x minus 5. Alright, so watch this. So my derivative, so now again I don't need implicit differentiation, just do my regular. So negative 1 times 3 is negative 3x to the negative 2 minus 4, and the derivative of minus 5 is 0. So let's write that derivative like this, negative 3 over x squared minus 4. Oops, sorry, 4. Let's plug in the x value that they asked me to get the derivative at, which was they wanted the derivative at x is 3. So if you plug in 3, negative 3, let's put a 3 squared here, minus 4. Work that out, negative 13 thirds. Same answer. So I did the last part just to show you that implicit differentiation just gives you another way. This problem was pretty easy to solve for y, but a lot of problems are not, and therefore implicit differentiation is your only way to go. So you want to be able to use both methods. All right, thank you. Hope this has been helpful.